Let us start a salt analysis. Let us take 0.1 molar aqueous solution of HCl. In this, concentration of H plus is 0.1 molar. To this, let us pause H2S gas. Let us pause H2S gas till H2S is past saturation. So we are getting a saturated solution of H2S. Saturated solution of H2S. Okay. Now, it is a resultant solution. In this resultant solution, what and all is there means HCl is there and H2S is there. HCl is present and H2S is present. HCl ionizing to give H plus ions and Cl minus ions. H2S ionizing to give HS minus ions, sulfide ions and H plus ions. So the resultant solution contains certain concentration of H plus ions, certain concentration of Cl minus ions, certain concentration of sulfide ions, certain concentration of bisulfide ions, and undissociated H2S. Undissociated H2S. These are the species present in the resultant solution. Okay. Now, undissociated HCl we have not considered because we are considering HCl as undergone complete dissociation. Since it is strong acid. Though it is strong acid, it will not undergo complete dissociation. It will undergo higher extent of dissociation. That extent of dissociation we do not know, so that we assumed complete dissociation. Sorry. Now, here, what are the equilibria possible? In this resultant solution, what are the equilibria possible? One is H2S gas gives H plus ions and HS minus ions. It is one equilibria. Another equilibria, HS minus gives H plus ions and sulfide ions. It is another equilibria. Now, at equilibrium concentration of HS minus H plus S sulfide. At equilibrium concentration of H2S, concentration of H plus, concentration of HS minus, we have to substitute. Now, here you have to consider that it is called this one and this one called, what is the meaning means, concentration of HS minus at equilibrium in the resultant solution, that is the meaning. The meaning is what you see that, this is called concentration of HS minus, it is also called concentration of HS minus. This is at equilibrium, this is also at equilibrium in the resultant solution. So this place and this place, what is the meaning? What is the meaning of this place and this place means concentration of HS minus at equilibrium in the resultant solution. That is the meaning. Okay. Sir. Now concentration of HS minus at equilibrium in the resultant solution is one value, isn't it? Therefore, what value you will write here? Same value will you write here or will you write different values? Will you write concentration of HS minus here and here different or same? What shall we write? Concentration of HS minus here and here. Do we write different values or same values? What will you do it? What is the meaning of this one and this one is concentration of HS minus at equilibrium in the resultant solution. That is the meaning here and here. Okay. That is the meaning. So what value will you write at this place and at this place? Will you write same value or different values? That you say. So in this place concentration of HS minus, in this place concentration of HS minus, will you write same value or different? Okay. You are saying that same value we will write. Sir. So you are saying that concentration of HS minus here and here, how it is there means you said same value. Okay. Next point. Here concentration of H plus. This is what is the meaning of this one means it is the concentration of H plus at equilibrium in the resultant solution. This is also called concentration of H plus at equilibrium in the resultant solution. That is the meaning. This is concentration of H plus at equilibrium in the resultant solution. See that it is called concentration of H plus at equilibrium in the resultant solution. This is also called concentration of H plus at equilibrium in the resultant solution. Okay. So this place and this place meaning is same. What is the meaning? It is H plus concentration at equilibrium in the resultant solution. It is H plus concentration at equilibrium in the resultant solution. So what do you think about value here and here? Meaning we have seen. Here what is the meaning? Here what is the meaning that we came to know. Now you say, what is the value you will say here? What is the value will you say here? Will you say here and here same value will you say? Or different value will you say? And also you have to understand another point. It is not meaning of this is not mean that H plus from H to S. Understand it clearly. This does not mean that H plus from only H to S. Okay. This does not mean that H plus from only H to S. Okay. This meaning is H plus at equilibrium in the resultant solution. That is the meaning. In the resultant solution, H plus is there. Can you segregate? These are the H plus ions from H to S. These are the H plus ions from HCl. These are the H plus ions from HS minus. Like this, can you segregate? No. Then this meaning is concentration of H plus at equilibrium in the resultant solution. That is the meaning. We should not say that it is a H plus from H to S only. Like this, we should not say. Because this solution contains this solution. In this solution, H plus is there. That comes from three different sources. One is from HCl, one is from H to S, one is from HS minus. Therefore, we have to see the resultant we have to see. Therefore, this place is called a concentration of H plus at equilibrium in the resultant solution. This place is also called a concentration of H plus at equilibrium in the resultant solution. Okay. So what is the meaning? Meaning we have understood. Sir. So meaning of this one we have got an idea. Sir. Next point we'll see. It is, you know that it is concentration of H to S at equilibrium, you know. It is concentration of sulfide at equilibrium, you know that. Sir. Now we will say the values. Sir. Concentration of sulfide at equilibrium is suppose Z. Concentration of HS minus at equilibrium is suppose Y. What shall I write here? Concentration of sulfide at equilibrium, suppose Z we have written. Concentration of HS minus at equilibrium in the resultant solution is Y. So I have written Y. What shall I write here? Okay, you are saying that Y. Sorry. Concentration of H plus at equilibrium in the resultant solution is suppose some D. What shall I write here? Concentration of H plus at equilibrium in the resultant solution, suppose D, what shall I write here? Sir, okay, you are saying D. Concentration of H plus at equilibrium, we have written. Sir. Concentration of H2S at equilibrium, suppose E. Sir. So, concentration of respective species, we have written. Concentration of respective species, we have written. Sir. Okay. It is a final result we have written. Now, in the exam, how the question will be asked? What are the given data? What are the given data? That we will see. So, one data given is this one. It is one data. This is one data. 0.1 molar aqueous solution of HCl is one data. Sir, what is another data? Another data is passing H2S gas till solution becomes saturated with H2S. It is second data. Third data, what is given means Ka1 of H2S. It is third data. Ka1 of H2S is equal to is given. It is third data. Fourth data is Ka2 of H2S given. That is this. These are the data given. Data given is what means? One is HCl concentration is given. Second data given is second point said as saturated solution of H2S. third point said as Ka1 equal 10 power minus 1. Fourth point said as Ka2 is equal 10 power minus 14. Now the question is, what is the concentration of all the species in the resultant solution at equilibrium? That means we have to say Z value, Y value, D value, E value. We have to say these values. So how to calculate? So to calculate, what shall we do? That we will see. Okay, we have seen actual meaning. We have seen. Now we have to go for calculation. Using the given data, how to proceed? That we will see. Proceed, and our final goal is resultant solution at equilibrium. That is the final goal. So we have to start from beginning. Sorry. So using the given data, let us start from beginning. At last, we should reach resultant solution at equilibrium. Sorry. Now we will start. So starting point. Starting point initially H2S is 0.1 molar. Sir, it is dissociating. How much dissociating means? Suppose x molar. So at equilibrium it is 0.1 minus x. Sir, now before H2S we pass, in the solution HCl is there, that is giving 0.1 molar H plus. H2S is dissociating x molar, therefore it is producing x molar H plus. So that up to now H plus how much produced means 0.1 plus x. Now we have written this value at equilibrium by proceeding step by step. First step here, second step here, we have not gone for third step. That means final resultant solution at equilibrium is not this one. We are proceeding step by step in order to do the calculation. First step this one, we are coming for second step, then we are going for third step, then we will say resultant solution at equilibrium. Okay, so for that sake, so we will proceed step by step. Okay, so first we have taken HCl. HCl concentration is 0.1 molar. We are passing H2S. We got saturated solution of H2S. In the saturated solution of H2S, concentration of H2S is 0.1 molar. H2S is dissociating x molar. So remaining is 0.1 molar, 0.1 minus x molar. 0.1 molar H plus is coming from HCl. H2S is dissociating and giving this much H plus. Therefore, this much H plus we got. H2S dissociating x molar, therefore x molar HS minus we are getting. After HS minus is formed, HS minus is dissociating. Therefore HS minus present this much. HCl has given 0.1 molar H plus. H2S has given x molar H plus. HS minus is giving Y molar H plus. Therefore, H plus is present 0.1 plus X plus Y. HS minus is dissociating Y molar. Therefore, sulfide is Y molar. So, now in the resultant solution, H plus is there. H plus in the resultant solution is HCl is providing this much. H2S is providing this much. HS minus is providing this much. Sir, concentration of HS minus, in the resultant solution, H2S is providing this much. HS minus is dissociating. So concentration of HS minus in the resultant solution equal to this much HS minus is from H2S. This much bisulfide is dissociating. Therefore, in the resultant solution, HS minus concentration is X minus Y. Okay. Now, we will take Ka1. Ka1 is equal to, right side you write in the numerator, that is H plus into HS minus by H2S. It is Ka1. Now, Ka1 we will write, this is called concentration of H plus in the resultant solution at equilibrium. This is called concentration of H plus in the resultant solution at equilibrium. Therefore, 0.1 plus x plus y. This is called concentration of HS minus in the resultant solution at equilibrium. That is x minus y. That is x minus y. Okay. Now, KA1 is equal to, this is the expression. You understand very properly. This is called concentration of H plus in the resultant solution at equilibrium. That value is this. This is called concentration of HS minus at equilibrium in the resultant solution, final solution. That is this much, X minus Y. By it is called concentration of H2S at equilibrium in the resultant solution. That is 0.1 minus X. Okay. Next, we will go to KA2. KA2 is equal to, right side we will write in the numerator concentration of H plus into concentration of sulfide by concentration of HS minus. Now, we will substitute this value. This is called concentration of H plus at equilibrium in the resultant solution. Therefore, this value is 0.1 plus X plus Y. This is called concentration of sulfide at equilibrium in the resultant solution. That is Y molar. This is called concentration of HS minus at equilibrium in the resultant solution. That is X minus Y. Sir, we substituted the values. Now, do we get any doubt till now? Do we get any doubt till now in the substitution? Any doubt is there? Sorry. Now, we have substituted KA1 formula, KA2 formula we have substituted. Now, we have to simplify. Why we have to simplify in the sense? They are asking concentration of different species at equilibrium, we have to say. Concentration of all the species, we have to say. Given data is what? What is the given data? One is KA2, second one is KA1, third point said the saturated solution of H2S. Saturated solution of H2S means they will say 0.1 molar H2S, that is third point. Fourth point is 0.1 molar aqueous solution of HCl. These are the given data. Given data, see, one is 0.1 molar aqueous solution of HCl. Second data is saturated solution of H2S contains 0.1 molar H2S. Third data is KA1. Fourth data is KA2. What is the question? Find concentration of all the species present in the resultant solution. That means we have to say, we have to get X and Y. Two variables are there. How to find it? Two variables and also complicated. These two are complicated. So, two variables are there and complicated. That means some approximation method we have to consider in order to solve. Complicated is coming in the sense immediately you have to think approximation as per the syllabus. So what is the approximation? That we'll see. So we are going for approximation method. Okay. So we are going for approximation. So why we are going for approximation? One point is here two variables, X and Y, two variables. They are unknown. Unknown variables are two. Another thing is this one and this one complicated. So simplifying these two, not easy. Such a type of situation arises which indicates we have to solve the problem by approximation. That is the meaning. That approximation we have to consider, that is as per the syllabus. Okay. So we have to go for the approximation. So what is the approximation? That we'll see. Now we will see KA2. KA2 is 10 power minus 14. This KA2 is 10 power minus 14. This indicates this equilibrium lies almost towards left. This equilibrium lies almost towards left. Okay. So KA2 says that KA2 indicates Ka2 indicates equilibrium lies almost left, almost towards left. Ka2 indicates that equilibrium lies almost towards left, sir. So this Ka2 value says that this equilibrium lies almost towards left. Okay, this Ka2 says that this equilibrium lies almost towards left. Therefore, we can say this x minus y as what? This x minus y we can consider as what? Now this Ka2 is 10 power minus 14. That means this equilibrium is lying almost towards left. So what about this y when compared to x? Now see that 10 power minus 14. It is 10 power minus 14. This meaning is it is 10 power 14 times greater than this concentration. See that this ratio is equal to 10 power minus 14. This meaning is this concentration is 10 power 14 times greater than this product. So shall we say y is negligible to x? Therefore x minus y is nearly equal to x. Sir, so you are saying that x minus y is nearly equal to x. Sir, that point we got an idea. So x minus y is nearly equal to x. Sir, so we got x minus y is nearly equal to x we got. Sir, next point we'll see. Next, we'll see that this H2S is 0.1 minus x is given. H2S is 0.1 minus x is given. Okay. Now, Ka1 is 10 power minus 7. Ka1 is 10 power minus 7. This meaning is concentration of H2S is 10 power 7 times greater than that of this product. See, this ratio is equal to 10 power minus 7, which means this concentration is 10 power 7 times greater than that of this product. So what do you say about x when compared to 0.1? What do you say about this x when compared to this 0.1? 0.1 and x, what do you say? Here this formula says that this ratio is equal to 10 power minus 7. What does it mean? This concentration is 10 power 7 times that of this concentration, this product. This concentration is 10 power 7 times greater than this product. That means 10 power minus 7 is the equilibrium constant. This equilibrium constant tells that this equilibrium lies almost towards left. This equilibrium is almost towards left because this concentration is 10 power 7 times that of this product. So this Ka1 indicates that equilibrium lies almost towards left. Okay, here this Ka1 tells that this equilibrium lies almost towards left. So what about x when compared to 0.1? Shall we say x is negligible to 0.1 or x is considerable to 0.1? What shall we say? What do you say regarding x and 0.1. 0.1 minus x. What shall we take? What shall we say? X is negligible to 0.1, shall we say? Or considerable on comparing to 0.1, shall we say? What shall we say? Sir. Now, x is negligible to 0.1, you are saying. Sir. That means 0.1 is nearly 0.1 minus x is nearly equal to 0.1. Sir, next point we'll see. So we have discussed x minus y and 0.1 minus x we discussed. Now we will see 0.1 plus x plus y. 0.1 plus x plus y. What shall we say? 0.1 plus x plus y. What shall we say? That we'll see. Now 0.1 plus x plus y. 0.1 plus x plus y. You said x is negligible to 0.1. Y is negligible to x. Correct? You see this point. Y is negligible to x. X is negligible to 0.1. Therefore, 0.1 plus x plus y is nearly equal to 0.1, you are saying. Sir. Okay. See, we have taken this approximation. Why? Because we have came for this approximation. Why? Because these two are having two variables, two unknown variables, and simplifying this is difficult. Simplifying this one and this one. Simplifying this one and this one is difficult because they are coming under quadratic equation, quadratic expression. Complicated one. So that only we have come for this approximation. Otherwise, no. Sir. Now we have taken the approximation. The approximation we will substitute here. We will substitute in this one. Sir. Now we will substitute the approximation here. Okay. So KA1, 10 to the power of minus 7 is equal to this is nearly 0.1. Okay. It is x minus y is nearly equal to x. Okay. This is 0.1. This 0.1. Therefore, x is equal to 10 to the power of minus 7 molar. Okay. Here approximation. KA2, 10 to the power of minus 14 is equal to this. This is approximately taken as 0.1. This y we will take. This x minus y we will take as x. Okay. Now, let us substitute this x. Let us substitute this x. We will get y. So, 10 to the power of minus 14 equal to 10 power minus 1 y by 10 to the power of minus 7. Therefore, y is equal to 10 to the power of minus 20. Y is equal to 10 to the power of minus 20. So, now we will go for conclusion. In this result and solution, different species concentration, let us say. Now, in this saturated solution, concentration of H plus, we'll say concentration of H2S, concentration of sulfide, concentration of bisulfide. This we'll say. Sir. Now, this y is called concentration of sulfide. Y is called concentration of sulfide. So y is equal to 10 power minus 20. That 10 power minus 20 we will write. Then, that is sulfide. Sulfide is y. So y is called sulfide. Sulfide concentration we are writing. Okay. Then HS minus. We will go for HS minus. HS minus is x minus y. HS minus is x minus y. X minus y is nearly equal to x, we said. So x is equal to 10 power minus 7. Therefore, HS minus is 10 power minus 7 molar. Okay. Next, H2S is 0.1 minus x. 0.1 minus x, we have said nearly equal to 0.1. So H2S concentration is 0.1 molar. Next, concentration of H plus is 0.1 plus x plus y. It is nearly equal to 0.1, we said. Therefore, concentration of H plus is 0.1 molar. Now, we got concentration of different species we got. Concentration of different species we got. So in the saturated solution of H2S, concentration of different species we got. Let us relate these concentrations with which value we'll see. With which value we'll see. Now we will take water. We will pass H2S gas. We will get a saturated solution of H2S. Saturated solution of H2S. Okay. See, we are taking water. We are passing H2S gas. We got saturated solution of H2S. In this solution, concentration of H2S we found 0.1 molar. Concentration of HS minus we found that we got 10 power minus 4 molar yesterday. Concentration of H plus we calculated that we got 10 power minus 4 molar. And the concentration of sulfide we calculated that we got 10 to the power of minus 14 molar. This we did yesterday. Sorry. Today we discussed, we have taken 0.1 molar aqueous solution of HCl. 0.1 molar aqueous solution of HCl. To this we passed H2S gas. We got saturated solution of H2S. In this saturated solution of H2S, concentration of H2S we got, we calculated that as 0.1 molar. Concentration of H plus we calculated, we got 0.1 molar. Concentration of HS minus we calculated that we got as 10 power minus 7 molar. Concentration of sulfide we calculated that we got 10 to the power of minus 20 molar. We calculated now, just now, we got 10 to the power of minus 20 molar. Now let us compare. Let us compare these values. It is saturated solution of H2S. It is also saturated solution of H2S. But the way in which attaining saturation is different. Okay. The way is like this. Now see the concentration of H2S in the saturated solution in these two places. That is 0.1 molar. Okay. Let us leave it this. Now you see the concentration of H plus here. 0.1 molar. Here you see H plus 10 power minus 4 molar. Here we got H plus only from H2S. Here we got H plus 1 from HCl, 1 from H2S, 1 from HS minus. Like this, 3 different sources. Sorry. Finally, we said we came to the conclusion that H plus in the resultant solution is nothing but HCl contribution. H plus in the resultant solution is nothing but HCl contribution, but not H2S and HS minus. H2S and HS minus also contributing H plus, but that contribution is negligible when compared to HCl contribution. Here in this solution, H plus is contributed by HCl, H2S, HS minus. HCl is contributing 0.1 molar. H2S contributes, HS minus also contributing. Contribution given by H2S and HS minus is negligible when compared to HCl. Therefore, we have written 0.1 molar we have written. So, you see that concentration of H plus you see, concentration of H plus you see. Sir, different. Why? Because we have taken HCl. Here we have not taken HCl. Therefore, and also we said concentration of H plus provided by H2S and HS minus is negligible when compared to HCl because we have taken HCl as 0.1 molar. Suppose if you take HCl is 10 power minus 4 molar, then will you neglect? That question also there. Okay. Now we will see concentration of bisulfide 10 to the power of minus 7. Concentration of bisulfide here 10 power minus 4. Why is it so? Think it. HS minus comes from only H2S. Here also HS minus comes only from H2S. In that there is no doubt. HS minus from H2S. Here concentration of HS minus is 10 power minus 7. Here concentration of HS minus is 10 power minus 4. Why is it so? Why concentration of HS minus is reduced when compared to this? That means what happens to the degree of dissociation of H2S year and year? Is it changed? Changed in the sense due to which the degree of dissociation is affected. Then compare concentration of sulfide year and year. Concentration of sulfide is 10 power minus 20 year, whereas here 10 power minus 14. Concentration of sulfide year is less when compared to this. Sulfide is coming from dissociation of bisulfide. Sulfide comes from dissociation of bisulfide. Here bisulfide dissociates to give sulfide. Here also bisulfide dissociates to give sulfide. Concentration of sulfide is varied means degree of dissociation of bisulfide is varied. That is the meaning, no? Why degree of dissociation of bisulfide is varied? Due to which is affecting degree of dissociation? Due to which concentrations are getting varied? What shall we say? Sir, here what are the equilibria possible? That we will see. In this solution, what are the equilibria possible? H2S aqueous is in equilibrium with H plus aqueous plus HS minus aqueous. You are saying that HCl. Okay, you are correct. HS minus aqueous is in equilibrium with H plus aqueous plus sulfide aqueous. Here, what are the equilibrium means? H2S aqueous is in equilibrium with H plus aqueous and HS minus aqueous. Then HS minus aqueous is in equilibrium with H plus aqueous and sulfide aqueous. You see the equilibrium, you see. Here in this solution, what are the equilibria possible? Same equilibria possible in this solution. But concentrations are different. Sulfide concentration is different. This indicates position of this equilibrium and position of this equilibrium is different. Concentration of bisulfide is different. This indicates position of equilibrium here and position of equilibrium here different. So now we will see here extent of forward. We will see extent of forward here.